Winning cures everything. Now for your hosts, Gary and Chris.
Oh, let's go ahead and move into our playoff predictions. And I'll go ahead and knock mine out. Of course, I do number 5 and 6 for who gets left out. I've got number 6, Utah. I think they win the Pac-12. I don't think they've got as good a wins as other people. And that loss to USC could end up being a bad thing. Because USC, I think, probably ends up 7-5. And if they lose to UCLA, maybe 6-6. I mean, there's no telling here. So USC, who everybody has thought has looked pretty good, still could end up with a not great record. So that loss on that Friday night at USC, not a good thing. But I think they can. Like, I think they'll probably beat Oregon. That defense is for real. They are so legit. So number 6, I've got Utah. Number 5, I've got Penn State. I think Alabama gets in at 4. I think Clemson ends up at number 3. And then I've got LSU 2 and Ohio State 1. I think Ohio State's metrics will make a big difference. And I think a lot of this will have to do with matchups. And I say what you will, this is a TV show. I think they want LSU and Clemson and Ohio State, Alabama. That would be the highest rated college football playoff that we have ever had. And it all has to do with matchups. So we'll see. I mean, they could toss Alabama and LSU in there together, Alabama at 4 and LSU at 1. But I don't know that there's a whole lot of difference between Ohio State and LSU. And, I mean, we'll see. We'll see, right? I mean, they could put Clemson in at 4. And you got LSU, Clemson 1-4, and Alabama and Ohio State at 2-3. But we'll see. Either way, those are my 4, Alabama, Clemson, LSU, Ohio State. Who you got in your top 4?
Last week, my 4 is not changing. It's LSU, Ohio State, Clemson, Penn State.
Yeah, that makes sense.
I think the committee is going to give Penn State the nod. I think the Alabama fatigue is a thing, and I think Penn State is just as big of a fan base nationwide. Maybe not as big, but still, you don't have the fatigue factor there.
Yeah.
And we've seen 2 SEC teams get in multiple times. They don't want that continuously. I think they would rather have 2 Big Ten teams that can certainly get it. If Penn State is undefeated and their only loss is at the Horseshoe, got that right?
Yep.
Against Ohio State, then I think that's a loss at home has to be worse than a loss on the road. It just has to be. Or why do we play home and road games? I mean,
You've got a point. I think they will look at Alabama because I still think Alabama loses to LSU, and I think that the committee looks at it as Tua coming off surgery, et cetera. And Tua, top 5 player in the country, I think that matters. So, but we'll see. Because they've kept Alabama in all of these, regardless of whether they win their conference or not.
I know.
And you might be right about the fatigue factor, and I guess it depends on the way that the game goes, because this could all change by next week. So we'll see exactly what happens with that.
But I think LSU has a better shot of getting in losing on the road over Penn State than Alabama has than getting in by losing at home, but having the excuse that, well, Tua was hurt.
Yeah, you might be right. So we'll see exactly how this goes. I mean, if Minnesota beats Penn State, this all goes
in the wash. Well, yeah, we're right. Projecting this right now the best we can.
Yeah. Now, you're right. Predictions are fun.
Projections.
Yep. Predictions are fun.
Make the happiest person in the world, and then we have a completely different conversation, and there we go.
There you go.
That's not going to happen, by the way.
All right, that's going to wrap up the college football playoff predictions and the college football top 10 after week number 10. Of course, you can go find us, winningcureseverything.com. If you're watching on YouTube, hit that subscribe button, share the show out, leave some comments, click the like button. Like this video if you enjoy us. We do appreciate all the support from you guys. You have been wonderful to us all season long. We're going to keep it rolling, of course. And go over to tunicatravel.com. They've got some great stuff in the works down at Tunica, Mississippi, the South's premier sports gambling destination. Make sure that you leave us a nice review if you're listening on the podcast. We really appreciate that. It helps us out a ton. It gets us in front of more people. If you want the community to grow like we do, knock that thing out for us. You guys have been great. We will see you all again tomorrow. Thanks for checking out Winning Cures Everything. If you want to keep up with us, hit subscribe on YouTube or your favorite podcast app. Visit the website at winningcureseverything.com, or you can like us on Facebook or follow us at Winning Cures, at Gary WCE, or at Chris B. Giannini on Twitter. Share out the show, leave a nice review, and make sure to comment and tweet at us.